Hey, what is going on, guys? My name is Amir, and damn, it's been a minute. I missed you guys. I missed making videos. And how do you guys like this new setup that we got back here? We got pears, we got a banana, and we got me. Anyways, it's good to be back, and today, with the new year starting, I want to talk to you about how you can get healthier and better hair in 2020. So these are some lifestyle choices that you can make, slash some habits that you can get into, slash some things that you can do that will result in giving you better hair. I'm excited to bring this video to you guys. So what the hell are we waiting for? Without any further ado, let's go ahead and jump right into the video. The first and foremost thing you should do starting this new year is invest in yourself. When I say invest in yourself, I don't mean like, you know, invest money or buy courses or start a new membership at a gym. All that stuff, yeah, you should do. But I mean, when it comes to the daily, everyday things that you put in your hair, right? Such as your shampoo, your conditioner, or your hair product, anything and everything that you use for your personal care. Spending a little bit of extra money for a quality product can help you go a long way. And these things that you may think don't really make a difference, when you actually go ahead and use these for a long period of time, that's when you actually see the real result. Okay, so let's say there are two people, okay? Both of them have some sort of genetic balding history or thinning hair or something like that somewhere down their genes, right? One uses a quality shampoo that is sulfate paraben free, infused with organic extract. Other one uses stuff that you get off your typical Walgreens and Walmart shelf, AKA Head and Shoulders, AKA Garnier, AKA Pantene Pro-V. A few years down the road, that's when you will really see the difference. The person who uses a quality product down the road, those nutrients that you go ahead and add onto your hair, eventually not only help you retain the hair, but also make it healthier and thicker. If you're someone who likes to style their hair on a daily basis, don't cheap out on your pomade or your putty or whatever you use to style your hair. Your hair product that you use to style your hair is gonna be staying in your hair until you go ahead and wash your hair. And for some people, I know I don't wash my hair for like 2-3 days, you know, because it's what you're supposed to do. So I know this stuff is gonna be staying in my hair for the next 2-3 days. And if you're putting crap in your hair, it's gonna take a heavy toll on the health of your hair. So that is why I always recommend using the Flux Pomade by Project & Co. This pomade comes from 100% certified organic extract. Some of the extracts that are in there are horsetail extract, which actually help with hair growth, as well as lemon peel extract. So if you have dandruff or anything like that, it also helps with that. Plus, also you get your added benefits of being able to style your hair. It's 100% water soluble, so you can always go ahead and wash it out if it's too harsh, but it's also strong enough to give you an all-day hold. So if you're looking for a quality pomade, Project & Co. Flux Pomade is the way to go. In the year 2020, commit to taking cold showers. If you take cold showers, not only are you gonna have your life changed and your mind blown because of the amazing benefits that you feel instantly afterwards of taking a cold shower, such as a boost in your mood, boost in energy, boost in testosterone, and an overall just confidence that you carry yourself in because of the fact that you're able to go ahead and challenge yourself first thing in the morning and be able to go ahead and pass that. In addition to that, cold shower is great for your skin and your hair. The biggest thing that they do for you is get your blood circulating. As painful as putting cold water all over your body, including your hair, sounds, when you get that blood circulating and that water just hitting your head in all areas that you can, that's actually helping you keep and maintain healthier hair and healthier skin. It doesn't even need to be like an everyday kind of thing. It's something that you can do maybe like 2-3 times per week, or it's something that you can just do like maybe at the beginning of your shower, take a cold shower and switch to a warm one, or you can, you know, just start with a warm shower and then eventually switch it off all the way to cold. Whatever you prefer, but that's just something, a personal commitment I'm making to myself to take more cold showers this year. This is something that I've done consistently like in the past for like, you know, 2-3 months straight, and I've seen the amazing benefits for it. So if you guys are considering, you know, serious self-improvement, serious self-confidence, and you really wanna actually go ahead and step into discomfort every single day while giving yourself healthier skin and hair, start incorporating cold showers into your daily routine. Limit your exposure to sun. If you live in an area where the sun is always shining, like, I don't know, California, Arizona, Miami, I don't know where else is the sun. I don't know, any parts of the world where it's always, where your hair is always under heat. As we know, heat is bad for your hair. And exposing your hair to direct sunlight every single day for long periods of time can produce a compound called superoxide, which basically causes your hair to go from the hair growth phase to the hair shedding phase. Here in Chicago is no issue because it's like 20 degrees outside, but in the summertime I know it does get hot, so that's something that I personally want to incorporate for the 4 or 5 months, or even for the 3 or 4 months that we have the summer. Also, in addition to that, if you're constantly tanning or something like that, you can also get sunburn on your head. Whenever you do go out, make sure to wear a hat or cover your head somehow and try to not expose your head the sun as frequent as possible. If you want healthy hair, repeat after me. In 2020, I will oil my hair. I kind of underestimated it. I just thought it was kind of like those woo-woo things that people just say, but it doesn't really work. But once I actually got on a consistent regimen, after like a week and a half or two, my hair, when I ran my hands through it, it just felt thicker, it felt healthier. And I know oiling your hair can be kind of like a pain in the butt, especially when you have to like kind of leave it in, wash it out with a shampoo it multiple times to make sure your scalp is 100% clean. But thankfully I came across a pretty dope product on Amazon. It's called Essie Natural Hair Growth Oil. This is like an oil that I actually put on every night before going to sleep. It's like a serum almost, so it's not as like oily as normal oil would be. So you just kind of put it on, you put it in your hair, and it just dries up. You can use it every single day. So for me, for my hair growth regimen, in the daytime I'll use Rogaine, and at nighttime before going to sleep I'll put this on, and the next day my hair is not going to be greasy, and it works. So if you're interested in like a daily leave-in kind of serum kind of oil, I highly recommend checking this out. If not, then you can always just use, you know, your normal castor, almond, and jojoba oil and mix it up in a blend and just, you know, do it the traditional way. And lastly, don't stress it, bro. Stress can take a heavy toll on your body, on your mood, on your life, your perspective, and a heavy toll on your hair. Stressing is one of those things that is directly related to baldness, and you know, we see people having gray hair and stuff like that. If you already have issues with your hair, whether it's just like thinning or balding, or you know, you're shedding hair, when you stress, you're just gonna speed up the process, unfortunately, even faster. Honestly, just give yourself the break that you deserve. It could be as simple as, you know, working out every day for, you know, like an hour, meditating, yoga, all that stuff that people say on YouTube but never do, including myself. Or you can just spend quality time with some of your close friends or family, or simply just take that well-deserved vacation that you always wanted to take but you've always been putting it off. Whenever I get back from a vacation, I feel even more energized and rejuvenated to like go harder, to work hard, make more money, and like constantly just strive to be better every single day. And when you're like constantly caught up in a workflow or something where you're just constantly stressed by your environment, it's just gonna paralyze you. And you, even if you think, hey, I'm just gonna grind this out, I'm just gonna work hard and all that kind of stuff, it eventually, you're not gonna be as motivated, and it's really gonna, you're gonna be stressed. On top of that, you're gonna be even more stressed because you're not performing as well as you should if you just went ahead and just took a break. So give yourself the break, give yourself the time to relax and enjoy and kind of, you know, chill out for a second. Not only will you see the quality of your life going up, also notice a significant difference in your workflow and your motivation. And also, can't forget what this video is about: your hair. Your hair is gonna look healthy, and not stressing too much is also gonna help you live a little longer. Put it in simple terms, if you are stressing all the time, not only are you gonna die sooner, but you're gonna die bald. Just let that sink in next time you're stressed. So yeah, anyways, hopefully you guys enjoyed this video. It feels good to be back. I wanna consistently, you know, get back on the YouTube game and, you know, consistently get back on making videos. I've just been so damn caught up with, like, you know, building other businesses and stuff like that. So kind of giving that stuff, like, you know, putting everything on a schedule so I can hop back on this, because, you know, we're actually at a pretty damn good pace. We're at almost 20,000 subscribers, which I had never imagined this channel actually getting to. So thank you guys so much for all your love and your support and everything that you guys have done, all your comments. Also, the next video, I want to do a Q&A, a little Q&A session with you guys on, you know, stuff you have, questions you have about, like, maybe hair, life, lifestyle choices, confidence, about myself. If you have any questions about me or my hair growth regimens or anything like that, let me know. I'll be more than happy to answer your questions. So leave your questions in the comment section below, because the next video or the video after that is gonna be a Q&A. I'm really looking forward to doing that video. Hopefully you guys did enjoy this video. Smash that thumbs up for the YouTube algorithm, as Graham Stephan says. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit that notification bell so you don't miss the next video. What else do people say? Yeah, I think that's about it. Other than that, I'll see you guys in the next one. Peace.